This must have been so much fun. Well, for the guests, at least. Does carrying this everywhere really make us better mates? Bernard seems to think so. Being invisible has always come easy to me. Maybe too easy.
Everything must disappear.
Makes us sound like magicians. Telling apart the treasure from the trash can be tricky sometimes. Mr. Spade? Mr. Spade? like prescription drugs. But what are they for exactly? You are going back to my cart. Should I call reception? Maybe they'll be able to help me make sense of all of this.
Hotel reception desk, Beth speaking. What can I do for you on this very fine day?
Beth, I need your help.
Sophie? What's going on?
I think Mr. Spade's stalking me while I work.
Really? I knew it!
You did?
I mean, I knew there was something fishy about him. He just has creep written all over his face, you know? How did you find out?
He took pictures of me. I found them hanging over the bathtub. He set up a kind of dark room.
Pictures of you? Doing what?
I can't believe I'm about to say this, but sometimes when I clean the rooms, I get a little curious and, you know, snoop through our guest stuff.
Mr. Spade caught you in the act, I suppose?
Yes. I think we should call the police.
No, that's a terrible idea.
But
Sophie, that man has pictures of you running your hands through people's stuff.
But I didn't steal anything. I was just snooping, I swear.
I know, but say a client reports something missing. Those pictures would put a big red target on your back.
Well, I threw them out.
Yeah, not your worst idea, but you found the pictures drying over the bath, right?
Yeah.
I'm no photographer, but I've been in one of those dark rooms before.
You have?
Yeah, I modeled for a while. Anyway, what I'm getting at is, those pictures were developed recently, but it doesn't mean there aren't more elsewhere.
You want me to keep digging around?
Well, there are pictures of you snooping. So why stop now?
Beth?
Oh, loosen up a little. No one's dead.
Any idea where I should start then?
Well, now that I think about it, I'm pretty sure I remember Mr. Spade asking for the combination to his old safe. I bet you anything there'll be more pictures in there.
Maybe, but I don't have the code. What?
I can't find the combination list. The night staff's probably lost it again. Anyway, we always ask that clients write down their code somewhere so they don't have to call reception a dozen times. Maybe you can have a look around the room, and I call you if Mr. Creep comes back. You know, so you can get out of there in time.
Okay. Yeah. Thank you.
Oh, it's nothing.
Oh, and Beth? Please keep this between us.
Of course.
I remember this sale. I picked up that new winter jacket for Mom. Harry's diner, too. Were we ever there at the same time? Beaver Lake? That's where I took Mom skating last month. Why is this up here? I just visited the oratory for the first time in years. This has to be a coincidence, right? Morgan. Is that your real name? Why did you check in under Mr. Spade? Something tells me you won't be missing this. One man's trash is another maid's trash. I hope you aren't eating those beans. Request to move to 507. Why did you want to change rooms? Mm-hmm. What do we have here? I'd forget my own head if I didn't write everything down. I guess we have that in common. Like you left with a long list of diagnoses and prescriptions. How are you supposed to support yourself when no one will give you a job or a place to live? You're pawning off your possessions? What do you need the money for? Did you intend for me to discover your little dark room? Or did this just fall down? That's a lot of film. How many pictures have you taken, Mr. Morgan? Damn it. Sophie.